Welcome. What a privilege to be here this morning. Thank you for being here. Welcome, baby Ruth. Whatever sounds she makes, let there be a reminder to us that we are preparing to welcome a baby, albeit the saviour of the world. Sing songs of hope into the waiting air and begin the dance of joy, for the life of faith is before us. Look into the distance and see the rising dawn with shining rays in acts of love and warming brightness from the heart of God. Follow the light that shines for you and leads you to a newborn child.
Lord, we have followed the light.
Come, listen for the voice that calls you to find new life in the broken corners of the world.
Lord, we have heard the voice.
Come, rich and poor, friend and stranger, gather round and share the celebration with the Prince of Peace.
Lord, we are here to meet with you.
Come, like wealthy kings with priceless gifts, or poor shepherds with only themselves to bring. For the Spirit has led you to this place, where you are offered the promise of new life. Lay down that which lies heavy upon us right now, some of which we'll pick up again later. But for now, this is the time, and this is the place, to know His love and His forgiveness. Lord, we receive all that you have to offer us. And may we know your passionate love that will never, ever give up on us. Thank you. Amen. As well as I can, an Advent reflection by Brian Draper daily during this Advent. His title for that is A Thrill of Hope. And on one of the days, he pointed out the word behold. And that really resonated with me, because some while ago, someone else picked up that word, behold. And it's a word which doesn't occur in the newer translations of the scripture. It's changed to look, or see, or learn. But in the King James Version, it occurs almost 1,300 times. So it matters. And it means more than just look at this. It means love deeply. Maggie Ross calls it pause to be vigilant. Look deeply. So I'm wanting us this morning to spend some time with that word, behold. Some of you will have been here often and will have sat looking out at the trees out here. This morning, as you look at the trees, may you behold the trees. Not only what you see, but all the years of their growth, all that lies beneath the ground, as well as above it. Aware of all the leaves that were there during the summer, that are now making compost. Look deeply. I'm going to read you a little verse or two of scripture where the word behold occurs twice. It's from Revelation chapter 21 and verse 3. I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. Behold your God. How would you take these words of scripture? Behold, I have seen the suffering of my people. Behold, I am sending my messenger. Behold, a virgin shall bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Behold, I will be with you always. Behold, I am making all things new. Can I invite you to sit with those scriptures for 5 minutes or so? Would you choose the one that God might be giving to you personally? Which is the one you really need to hear? That you need to hear him say to you, behold, I am, I have, I will be. Take the word for yourself right now. Giving and concern. Now I invite you to choose another word, another behold, that you sense that God would say to someone for whom you'd like to pray. For a situation related to COVID. To the universe. The planet. Wherever God takes your heart and mind right now. Find a behold and pray it into that situation. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now those who turn to him in their hearts. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And if you offer peace, would you please not move? Would you please behold one another a little? And share peace with your eyes. From being a child in the manger, Jesus grew to be the living Word, made flesh, offering everyone the bread of life. He travelled from the manger to the cross, where his body was broken and his love poured out. Jesus knew what was to come in that upper room. He took bread, broke it, and blessed it, and asked his disciples to remember how his life was given for them and for the generations to come. In the same way, after eating, he took the cup and asked them to remember how his love was poured out as a sign of the new relationship with God and for the forgiveness of sins. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them to be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ. Make us a Christmas people, secure in what has come and hopeful for what is yet to be. Keep us vigilant in our Advent waiting until Christ comes again and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Amen. When you have taken your bread and wine back to your place, can I invite you to simply hold them, behold them, until we have all got our bread and wine, and then we can eat and drink at the same time. And as you behold that bread, just maybe give a thought to where it's been, to maybe Canada, where the wheat was grown, to those who harvested it, to those who milled the flour and made the bread, to it coming here to this table and to you. Truly the bread of life. his life for that. Thank you for bread and wine, through which we have remembered your life and love. May we now be filled with your living word. Open our ears, that we may hear the cries of those waiting for love. Open our eyes, that we may see new possibilities around us. And open our lives to a different future, lit by justice and compassion, wisdom and peace. Amen. May the whole earth be renewed in its God. The universe resound with Christ's promise of coming life. And may the Spirit surround you with a cloud of grace. Amen. Amen. Walk in hope towards Christmas, carrying with you in kindness all that needs the blessing of love. A moment and make sure that you take away with you either one of the beholds to take into the day, or a phrase or a word or two from this service sheet that you'd want to hold with you within you today.